So if Minnesota summers are a battle between mosquitoes and construction, as of tomorrow, the mosquitoes are losing because construction downtown is about to suck all of the patience from our souls.
There are so many roads and bridges closing tomorrow that it begs the question, are we doing this right? Now, I know that sounds a touch pretentious, but today the comment was raised. Why don't we work around the clock to finish one project instead of working part of the day on 20 projects? Let's get some answers.
Let's be honest, roads need fixing.
It's certainly going to be different starting very soon to get in and out of downtown.
And a lot of them about to get some fixing all at once.
Access to and from downtown on I-35W will be closed for 4 months. The ramp from I-94 East to I-35W South will close until fall of 2021.
Okay, that's 3 years. If you walked, not even briskly, for 8 hours a day, you could walk around the world in less than 3 years. That's all of junior high. That's conception to pre-K, people. But it gets worse. As of 10 p.m. Friday night, count them up. Bridges, ramps, and roads will be closing on I-35W. Now that that feeling is settling in your gut, let's go back a minute. After the I-35W bridge collapsed, crews worked 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, to rebuild it. This cut the build time to 11 months. So why don't we apply this strategy to major highway road construction projects?
It does happen sometimes, although not every project can be done that way, and there's a few different factors that go into that. One can be nighttime noise. People who live near those construction projects don't like that banging, clanging, and beeping that goes on while construction is going on.
Good point.
And it also can bring up the cost when you're bringing in more crews to get work done a little bit quicker. And then there's safety. So if you're doing stuff 24 hours a day and you're out there at night, then you're also going to run into some safety issues.
MnDOT spokesperson Kirsten Klein also mentions logistics. Utility crews can't work at the same time as pavers. It's just different than a fallen bridge.
There's approximately 200,000 vehicles per day that are kind of in this construction zone. Yeah. And if you close it down completely, where do you move that traffic to? Because you don't want it going through all of the neighborhoods either. You can't necessarily bring in more crews or more people doing more work because it doesn't necessarily make it go quicker.
Now I feel badly. It was a good question, but she had some better answers.
Sometimes it turns out that way.
It turns out that way sometimes. Felt like an angry Facebook messenger, you know? And I'm like, oh, I didn't realize exactly what you're talking about. But the bridge is just different, right? I mean, it's a different mission. It's a different situation. It was closed no matter what because it had fallen. There's tons of funding for it, so they want to work around the clock. They had incentives to do it. It's just different. And they have, like she said, 200,000 commuters that are trying to get to that I-35 corridor every day.
So I want to know from you, I just got traffic anxiety because I have to go to the airport tomorrow night. And I'm like, wow, how am I going to get there? And how am I going to get home? So is traffic anxiety worse, traffic construction anxiety worse than winter driving anxiety? You tell us. Hashtag BTN11 on Twitter because I really need to know right now.
Fair question.
Whoo!